It never fades away. It's staying. Your kiss like broken glass on my skin. And all the greatest loves end in violence. It's tearing up my voice, left in silence. Baby, it hits so hard, holding on to my chest. Maybe you left your mark, reminding me to forget. It doesn't matter where you are, you can keep my regret. Baby, I got these scars, reminding me to forget. Reminding me I got these scars to get your love.
Sandwiches, croissants, cappuccinos. That's all they had to say.
Salt. Look how big this Great Beam is. Holy crap. Wowzers. Huge. Oh my god. He's so big. Hi. Oh my goodness. Big boy. Wow. Oh my goodness. That is literally crazy.
We're pretty tired. Like, I have to admit, I'm exhausted.
Well, we're jet lagged, so I feel like we don't go to bed.
We go to bed like at 2 in the morning. Well, Julia usually falls asleep at like midnight, and then I wake her up at 1, and she doesn't fall asleep till like 2:30.
But I'm just really
But we're
tired.
Also just like tired from the previous days. It's been like a lot.
From months ago. We've been tired for a few months.
Every time I'm leaning on you, you don't make it easy, no. Wish I could be there for you. Give me a reason to. Oh, every time I'm walking out, I can hear you telling me to turn around. Fighting for my trust and you won't back down. Even if we gotta risk it all right now. I know you're scared of the unknown. Control, and you'll be left in the dust unless I stuck by you. You're the sunflower. I think your love would be too much, or you'll be left in the dust unless I stuck by you. You're the sunflower. You're the sunflower.
Cool little spot. Well, well, well. What do we have here? Shout out to Aya for this scrumptious looking thing.
Mm-hmm. Boulangerie.
Yeah, this will be the best. Like, it's
yeah, so that crispy. Looks really good.
Aya, what the heck?
Okay, let's try it. Oh my god. That. It was worth it. Oh my god. It's so good. That's better than anything we've had.
Julia needs a bathroom, so I am at this little coffee shop getting an Italian espresso. Which is at the toilet. Kind of a cool little cafe.
Right at the famous Louvre Pyramid. So pretty. Trying to get a good photo. It's gorgeous, like a glass pyramid. They do a lot of fashion shows in here and stuff. It's really pretty in person. For a second, for a minute, can it go? For a second, for a minute, can it go? For a second, for a minute, can we go? Okay, so we're just taking a little breather in this beautiful park on the way to the museum, and we just wanted to have a little downtime for a second.
I'm tired.
Just to enjoy ourselves.
I want to take a nap.
Walking a lot. We walked like 9 miles yesterday, but it's good because we haven't eaten as much bread. We need to exercise.
That's what the 9 miles. Some people run that every day.
I know, right? We need to run that every day.
We need to run more. We need to work out. Mm-hmm. I'm ready to go ham once we get back in town.
Yeah, we need to like get healthy. We've been on the go for too long. Too long on the go.
Funny
No, okay. I think we should go to the museum. Actually, we're running a little bit out of time. We don't have too much time. We're doing a champagne tour tonight. That'll be fun.
Woo!
I'm actually really excited
for
that. It's on a boat near the Eiffel Tower. We're going to see it sparkle. So, that'll be exciting. Anyways, we're going to go to the Musée d'Orsay. Which is just 10 more minutes that way, so we need to start walking. So we'll see you at the museum, show you what it looks like.
The what museum?
Musée d'Orsay. We're gonna go see Picasso.
Musée d'Orsay. We just finished the tour. We gotta hurry up and leave. We're kind of in a rush. We have to walk back to our Airbnb.
We're going on a champagne tour, but at least we got to see Monet, Van Gogh, and Picasso. That's pretty awesome.
Really cool.
Yeah.
I liked Van Gogh, I think, the most, other than that one painting that we really liked.
Yeah, I liked it. We gotta change and freshen up. And it's gonna be floating on the river. And you get to try different champagnes, and yeah, I'm really excited. We're gonna see the Eiffel Tower sparkle, which we haven't seen yet. So we're gonna walk back to the apartment, and then we'll bring you along the champagne tour. Okay. Arrived to the port where all of the boat tours take off, and we're about to get on our boat for our champagne tour. There's the Eiffel Tower in the back, and we'll show you when we get on the boat, but we're just waiting to get on. When we hit the bottom, nothing gonna stop us. I'm to the top, and you,
we could be the greatest ones who never lived. And we're waiting for our champagne.
And they're gonna give us 3 champagnes, but I think the best part is just like floating on the river. Like seeing the Eiffel Tower sparkle, do you think it'll get dark?
Yeah.
That's the point.
This was like a champagne tasting on like a sunset cruise that you get to see part of the city of Paris. So yeah, we're excited.
So excited. I haven't seen the Eiffel Tower sparkle yet.
We'll try to keep you posted throughout the evening.
Yeah.
And then we'll take you to dinner with us.
Mm-hmm.
And then to the Ritz-Carlton. What's the place called?
The Hemingway Bar. Should we do that first or after?
First. Alright, well, I'll see you in a bit.
Okay.
We're gonna put it away for a second as he's talking history, and we'll learn a little bit of history of these different monuments around the river.
Starving.
I'm already hungry.
Oh, Bar Hemingway.
TBH, I want to eat.
When I first saw the Eiffel Tower, I wasn't that impressed. I was like a little underwhelmed.
It's beautiful.
But looking at it a second time, at this time of day, it's amazing. It's so, so overwhelming pretty. And it's beautiful.
Here at sunset.
It's like our favorite part for sure. My favorite part about Paris.
Totally, it's the Eiffel Tower. It's definitely my favorite part. We just got off the boat from our champagne tour. And we need to strategize about dinner. We don't know where we're going. What do you think, actually? Like, on a real note. Should we go to L'Avenue?
I emailed them.
You did? Oh my god, doesn't my eye look droopy? Look at that. It's like droopy.
Hey, how hungry are you?
I'm like starving and I have to pee.
Do you want a baguette? Oh.
Probably so good, actually.
I will buy you anything. I'll buy you anything you want from Balenciaga. Anything. If you take a big ass chunk out of that bread right there.
It actually looks quite untouched.
Yeah. Just don't bite one of these sides. Bite like the top
side. Oh, it's soft. No. Nope. I need like a crisp. That's stale.
Take a bite.
There's some like onions on
there. I will buy you anything you want from Balenciaga. Okay, what about a Chanel purse?
Okay, maybe I would do it for Chanel purse.
Okay, deal.
But I know our budget and we're not buying a Chanel purse.
Okay, but the budget is thrown out the door if you take a bite out of that breadstick.
No.
By the way, look at this beauty.
This dress is actually not that expensive. So we came to the Ritz-Carlton to go to the Bar Hemingway, which is like a beautiful bar.
It's really cool. There's a wait, so very fancy we're hotel. Waiting like, I don't know, probably 10 minutes or so. Jeez, my legs are hairy as heck. Hella hairy. I'm like Sasquatch in here.
Put a rose on mine. So pretty. The prettiest cocktail I've ever seen. And Hunter Rock. Pretty one too.
Yeah.
All I know is we could go anywhere, we could do anything, girl, whatever the mood we're in. Yeah, all I know is
alright, you guys, so here's our hot bath situation. The water here gets really hot. Okay, it's bath bomb time. That we picked up the other night from Lush.
Anywhere with you feels right.
Here
anywhere with you feels right.
Our bath bomb. It's like this, it's bright blue, which I'm not a fan of the blue, but it smells really good. Okay, so I want you to see it thin. Oh my god, that's so satisfying.
Morning. Oh, it's like the first day I feel refreshed.
Oh, I know. I still feel tired though.
I'm like finally awake. I probably look tired still. I don't know if you can see the bags under my eyes.
It's the first day.
You
should close
that.
The first day that we slept in, we woke up early and going to bed late every single night.
Yeah.
Which has not been good for our sleep. We're gonna like be so tired when we get home.
I feel pretty good though now, honestly.
Yeah. Yeah, I feel good too. Rested.
Yeah, so today, it is day 4?
Yes.
Or day 5?
The last day in Paris.
Yeah, so today is Thursday. We have Friday tomorrow, which is a Versailles tour. We're doing the bike Versailles tour.
Mm-hmm.
It's a fat tire tour is what it's called.
That's the company.
Yeah, it's the company. But it's a Versailles, so it's literally all day. We'll take you with us obviously tomorrow. But today it's pretty much a laid back day. We're gonna go see the gardens. What are they called?
Luxembourg Gardens.
And then we're going to...
And should we do any, like, touristy stuff today? Well, I mean, not as touristy and so is Montmartre, but I feel like we haven't been going to, like, museums and doing, like history lessons or anything like that.
I would love to go, like, learn history.
How, though? I don't know what to do. Like, I feel like every day we come back and we're like, what did we do today?
Yeah.
I mean, we've been seeing everything.
I can look up a quick, like, history tour.
Yeah,
we've been feeling like we haven't got much of the history. We've been going to like all the different sites and stuff, and it's cool to like see the sites. But like yesterday when we did that champagne tour, it was cool to hear the guy talk about like the different bridges and stuff and like the different buildings, like when they were built and what they were built for. And I think that's the piece we're missing out on right now. So we definitely desire that. I know tomorrow at Versailles, that'll be more like historical for sure.
But we haven't like just enjoying the city, I guess. We haven't, you know, like a lot of people come and they do, I think, like a lot of like the regimented like touristy stuff, but we've been like just enjoying.
Yeah, we've been having fun. So it feels
walking around.
We've been walking around.
We've been walking around a lot.
I feel like we haven't really had a chance to enjoy yet either because we've been so busy just moving from place to place.
I know.
I don't know where there's a cool place that you can do like the quintessential Paris thing of going and sitting down, having like a baguette, some cheese, and some meats. We haven't had that experience yet.
Well, we're gonna do that tomorrow. You know, you have to go get it yourself. You know, it's not like.
Yeah, but I'm saying like I guarantee you there's like a cool like lunch cafe, like a lunch spot that just
you
like.
Want to research a place for us to go?
So you I have fun. You don't know where we're going?
Well, I know we're going to the Luxembourg Gardens, but I don't know where we're going to lunch.
God, I look disgusting.
No, you don't.
Just my eyes.
I know, I feel really puffy.
I feel like my face has doubled in size over the past.
It's probably just like all the bread is making us, like my nose looks kind of big, like puffy. But by the way, when I get home, I'm getting a spray tan. I'm like so pale.
I kind of like it.
How many freckles I have.
I kind of like your spray tans. I mean, I kind of like your just natural color.
Really? I have like a lot of freckles. I never noticed them. Unless these are like, do you see that? Look at all the freckles.
I mean, you do have a lot of freckles.
I guess they're probably sunspot. Actually, I have
freckles right here. Freckles are really cool. So it's kind of funny. I used to have like so many freckles on my face. I was like a freckle face. So many freckles.
Yeah, that's what Taylor said. He told me that.
Really? I don't know.
Yeah, and there used to have tons of freckles. I'm like, really?
Where'd they all go?
I don't know. Where did they go? Well, damn. Just to have, like, the routine.
I was just zoned out thinking about something. You know, in Colorado, in Horn Creek?
Yeah.
There's, like, skit night every night?
Skit night?
Or, like, not every night. There's once a year, there's a skit night where you can like do like random skits or songs or like do like a hidden talent or whatever.
Yeah.
A talent show or skit night. But one year for skit night, Granddad and me did a skit together.
Mm-hmm.
And I was like really young. I was probably like Clay's age probably. I was probably 4. And they put me in a suitcase. Have I told you this before?
I don't know.
They put me in a suitcase and Granddad like wheeled me out in the suitcase. So he wheeled me out, and they didn't know like what was in the suitcase. But Granddad just like slowly walks onto like the stage, like the performance area, and unzips the suitcase and pulls me out. And I act like I'm a puppet, and he's like a ventriloquist.
Nice.
And he sits me on his knee, and like he does both of our voices. But when he squeezes my neck, like I open my mouth.
Yeah.
And the whole skit was like him as a ventriloquist, but I was his like puppet.
That's so funny.
And. I think Amy did my makeup where she did like this.
Yeah.
She did one of these things. And then she did like the freckles on my face. Like the 3 freckles, like look, made me look like a wooden boy.
That's so funny.
Yeah. Kind of funny.
What would you name that?
Freckles.
Oh. Thanks.
But I was so young. I can't believe I remember that.
How little were you? You do like have a weird memory, like you remember everything.
I was probably 3 or 4.
That's really young.
I was Clay's age or younger.
Well, I could see Clay remembering something like that. Clay's our nephew. He's so cute. Oh, I miss them. I bet they'll go to the fair, yeah?
Clay, who I was just talking about, he is my brother, Trent, and his wife, Valley's son. And he's 4, 4 and a half. And then his younger brother, Dodger, is 2 and a half. He's not 3 yet, is he? No.
No. My makeup has not been going on the same. I think it's because I'm not tan. And I brought the wrong colors of foundation.
I also think something about the humidity here is different than like the humidity we're used to.
Yeah, or like the water.
Like the salt content or the water or something.
Makes our hair really dry, which is
my hair's been so dry.
And skin. I think that's why my makeup's not going up very well. So dry.
It's funny that this yellow color's in right now. Cause it's kind of like McDonald's color, like mustard.
Yeah.
But I kind of like it. This is a pretty chill Airbnb. This is like a perfect spot for you to do new makeup.
I know.
That's a fact.
I actually have no complaints about the Airbnb in terms of like lighting and like space. Like, it's been really good for that.
Yeah.
It's not very homey.
I think it's fun. All you need is a place to sleep and a place to like store your stuff and at least a refrigerator to keep like your cold waters in.
That's true.
Or a safe to put your waters in because you hide all my waters. You drink all of them, so I have to hide them.
You just can't keep that.
Okay, you know the riddle, the five gallon, three gallon riddle, and you have to make 4 gallons? I just taught Julia how to do it. There's 2 ways. Let's see if she remembers them. Julia, how do you do the 5 gallon, 3 gallon riddle?
Okay.
I literally, like 10 minutes ago when I was showering, I walked her through both the options. Let's see if she can remember them.
Okay. So the first one, you fill up the 5 gallon. The first one, you fill up the 5 gallon bucket and you pour it in the 3.
Yep.
Then you have 2 left in the 5. So you pour the 3 out.
Mm-hmm.
And you fill the 3.
If you just
pour. No, you pour the 2 in the 3. Then you fill a 5 back up, pour one more.
You level off the 3.
Yeah, you pour one more in the 3 and then you have 4 left.
Okay, that's one way.
That was close.
What was the other way?
The other way is you start with a 3 gallon, you pour 3 gallons of water in the 3 gallon bucket. And you pour that in the 5.
Okay.
You have 3 left in the 5, okay. Then you would fill up the 3 again.
Mm-hmm.
But you wouldn't pour 2 more in there or just make 5.
Yeah.
Oh yeah, you would pour 2 more in and then you have 1 left over.
In the 3.
In the 3.
Dump out the 5.
Dump out the 5.
Pour the 1.
Pour the 1 in
to the 5.
The 5. Then pour 3 more in and then 3 more in the 5 and then you have 4. Oh my god, that's close. I swear my god. Logic like does not make sense.
Julia's logic with numbers in general.
I'm not a numbers gal.
She's an English person. She's really good with writing.
Yes.
She's good with writing. She's good with that's about it.
I'm good with art.
You're good with art. Me and you both are good with art.
Art, writing.
I'm art and math.
Yeah. It's an interesting mix, actually.
I'm art and math. You're art and reading. That means our kids are gonna be artists.
Oh, what was like? Tell us. Whoever's watching your subject
that you were good at
down below.
Yeah.
I like hearing what people. Everyone's like so different. Like people you would not expect.
Actually, I don't know if it's because of like my math, my logic alongside my art, if that's what made me good at psychology or not. But I just really grasped psychology and understood it and really enjoyed it.
Yeah.
But that's not really a subject. Almost, I feel like
the
main core subjects: math, reading, writing. History. Oh, I loved history.
Yeah.
I still love history.
Loved history. Oh, I forgot my eyeshadow. I'm like, what am I doing?
I was good at math. Loved history. I'm good at art.
Yeah.
You're good at reading and writing. Were you a good reader?
I wasn't a good reader.
As I never liked it. And all the patients.
Same.
Like ADD.
Same.
I can't do it. But I love to, like, learn when I read. It's weird. You think I would.
Okay, well, we're going to finish getting ready. And...
God, my hair probably gonna get some breakfast, and we'll see you at the Luxembourg Garden.
Yeah, we'll take you to breakfast with us, actually. This is where we're gonna go. I have no idea. I'm gonna do some research right now, so we'll see you in a bit.
Okay. I don't have a mirror, so I'm using the camera as my mirror. I have a mirror, we have our converter for our curling iron plugged in over here, so I have to do curling iron right here. So I guess I'll show you guys how to curl my hair.
Pre-sliced cheese, pre-sliced salami, and a baguette. That's a really cool idea. Interesting.
It's a beautiful day. I mean, it's like a spring day. Little bit, turn my...
All right, we just got the first piece of our lunch, which is our coffee. And we got our nice little sparkling water.
My favorite thing ever. I don't know why I like it so much. They put a spoon in it. Oh, watch out, you're spilling it out.
As good as gone, wake up at dawn, wonder if I put them on like Benita Applebaum. If they tell me I'm the shit that they wanted all along, would I still feel like the king and the bishop and the pawn? But while they've been sleeping, I've been scheming, I've been building rocket ships to put my team in. Start the countdown, cause believing everybody take a seat. Hi, this is your captain speaking.
Thank
God.
Come back later,
maybe.
Did you already pay, right?
Mm-hmm. My hair looked really curly today.
The way it dried
air.
So good.
I used the way this morning.
I'm having a good hair day.
Dry air.
I think this, I like the terrace water. It's really good for my hair. It kind of makes it dry. So like it's not oily or flat. It's just so good. Like it looks really good. Her hair never looked good.
I like this spot. I would recommend this spot.
Highly recommend. 10 out of 10.
It's like perfect little like French cafe. It's like the
this
most.
This would be the thing. First place that I'm like, you have to go here if you would Paris.
Yeah.
This is definitely a spot. Go for lunch, really. Yeah. Even though it's been packed every time we come by for dinner.
Cool. Yeah, the dinner actually looks really cozy. When we're like walking somewhere to another restaurant and we come by here for dinner, a lot of people have like a glass of wine and like a creme brulee.
We're gonna do that.
So I might do that tonight. We should come back here.
Yeah.
And they have a little garden over there too. You can eat in the garden. We're out on the front like area. I'll give you a view. So there's the garden over there. You can like eat in the little garden area.
I love the umbrella.
Or this is where we're sitting, like just outside on the, what do they call them, a patio? What is this called?
Yeah, the
front,
patio.
The front. And so everyone's just kind of eating out here. Everyone's walking by. It's really good people watching. Paris is so fashionable.
So fashionable. I know, I feel like I need to step my game up after being here in Paris. I need more chic.
Yeah, and I like the whole idea behind layers. Everyone has like multiple layers on.
And it's like not like about like looking super like good and showing off your body. It's just like purely fashion.
Fashion and like,
more. And more, well yeah, it's kind of cool. Even though it's a beautiful day outside.
Yeah, really cool spot. I actually really like that everyone just kind of chills and like
chills.
Has a coffee, some
they're like
cigarette.
All related to their family, yeah, friends, awesome. And just like, yeah, it's like relaxed. I like that.
So relaxed, so cozy.
the weather's beautiful.
Does it ever rain here? Is that why like everyone eat outside everywhere?
Does it rain? I don't know, I guess not. Does it not rain here?
Does it not rain in Paris? Let us know.
Yeah, okay, we're gonna wrap up lunch and then we're headed to the Luxembourg Garden.
Yeah. What other places do our followers live that we should come visit?
Yes.
Let us know.
Okay, we'll see you at Luxembourg.
We'll catch up in here in a little bit.
Yeah. Okay, so we just got to the Luxembourg Garden.
So beautiful.
So pretty.
We're just like at the entrance and it's already beautiful.
Taking a stroll.
Oh, look how pretty the stars
are. It's gorgeous, look. Oh, stunning. I love the fences with the black and gold. It's really pretty. I fall to pieces, babe, but you'll never know. I follow all my demons beyond control. Don't give me all your reasons. You sell your soul. You know I'm sticking to my guns. That's all I know.
Yes, why the stress? Get it off your chest. Niggas think I'm lucky, I prefer I'm blessed.
So we're still in the Luxembourg Gardens and this cute little cafe is like in the park. I really like parks.
I have a new appreciation for parks after visiting Europe. I feel like we need to go to parks more and just like relax, take a book. Garden. So pretty. It's a beautiful day. It's literally like a summer day. It like feels so like it's like 75 like degrees. So yeah, the best day for sure. Oh, there's dust on our lens. Huh? We need to treat this camera with better care. We just rough it around, don't we?
Look how pretty she is.
Okay.
Let's so beautiful. Baby, that's the love that you give. That's what you get now. Baby girl, we're using her head to get ahead now. Baby girl, she asked where I live. I said the penthouse. She don't even got any friends. Live at a friend's house. Baby, that's the love that you give. That's what you get now. Baby girl, we're using her head to get ahead now. Baby girl, she asked where I live. I said the penthouse. She don't even got any friends. Live at a friend's house. I fall to pieces, baby. Yeah, we need to get postcards for our family. Oh, they're cute. They're like vintage. Oh, that's cute. I like that one. Okay, we didn't get any postcards. Look at all the vintage books and posters. I like this. This is cool. Are pretty. Love to get some of these for like my office. It's kind of cool. Okay, so I think I'm gonna get this one for my office and maybe frame it in like gold or something. So I found a few posters. I got this one. And this one? We got the YSL. You showed them the YSL.
Yeah. This, I don't know what it says, but I thought it's pretty. And then this one I love. This is Monte Carlo.
Monte Carlo.
That's all DPF. And I'm gonna put them, I think, next to each other in my office and frame them like in gold. I'll fall to pieces, babe, but you'll never know. I'll follow all my demons beyond control. Don't give me all your reasons. You sell your soul. You know I'm still.
That's really pretty. Look at that. That's a church. That's insane. And we're like way downhill. I don't know if you can see how many people are up there. We're like way at the bottom of this hill.
Okay, we're at Montmartre. So we're gonna walk all the way up that hill so that we can get a really good view of Paris. I feel like it will be worth it. Oh, this is gorgeous. She recommended two boulangeries too. So you can already, oh, it's gonna be pretty. We could use some stairs after all the croissants we've been eating. See you at the top. Okay, we're at the top. So pretty. So we've just been enjoying the view up at Montmartre. And I think we're gonna head back to the Airbnb. Maybe change and then go have some dinner. Tomorrow we're going to Versailles, so we have to get up a little bit early. So it might be kind of a mellow night, even though I really want some rosé. What about you? You want a beer?
So I'm looking for the pointer.
Oh, you want to buy a beer from that guy?
Walking around selling beers.
You're like, want one so bad. Yeah. Beer at sunset. Yeah. Actually, I changed my foundation today and I'm liking it much better. Maybe I'm just was not like the foundation I was wearing, but this one is Huda Beauty. I love her makeup. So good. I give you that €1, use it for the water. It's okay, we'll wait till dinner. You don't want to ride a bird after a beer. Oh yeah, we got birds. We couldn't record on the birds because it's too difficult to ride. Yeah, you've done it before. When we were in Dallas, we did it. This makes me want to explore Dallas more. Dallas, I don't know why, like, just being like, exploring cities and stuff, I'm like, we need to explore our own city, you know?
Starving.
Where are we going?
I'm hangry. Going just across the river bend to get falafel.
Are we getting across the river?
Yeah, we have to cross the river.
Nice.
I just realized that there's like a left bank and a right bank.
What? No, you didn't.
I didn't know that the river was a split.
Yeah, so they explained it. One, your mom already explained that to us. Shout out to Nancy.
Thanks, Nance.
And then two, on the boat ride yesterday, they explained that also.
I didn't catch on to that. I don't know
they
why.
They go, we're going upstream, and so on the right, that's the left bank, and on the left, that's the right bank.
Oh, right, I do remember him saying that, but yeah. I didn't put two and two together.
Well, yeah, because you're not, I'm a math person. Never put two and two together.
I'm not a math person. Wait, did we tell him the bucket?
Yeah.
Okay.
We told you all the bucket story this morning.
Bucket story.
Feeling alive after our night's sleep last night. I feel like I woke up a little bit.
I feel like a new person.
I feel like a whole new person. A whole new. People hate when they walk around this camera here in Paris.
I know.
Not big fans.
But when I'm way up here, it's crystal clear. Now I'm in a whole new world with you.
Now I'm in a whole new world.
Unbelievable skies, indescribable feelings.
Well, that's interesting art over there. That's cool. I'm digging it.
Okay.
All right, so we're going to get some falafel that we heard was really dang good.
Yeah, we're excited.
So,
hungry.
We're on our way there. God, I love all the little stores here.
All the little stores. We've got all the stores, all the things.
We are walking towards the river.
Just across the river bend.
I knew she was about to sing that. All right.
There?
Where?
There. If you haven't figured out that we're fat asses by now, then you've figured it out.
And you won't ever figure it out. If you haven't figured it out yet, you'll never know.
Clearly, I don't know, doing something wrong. Now we're on the river bend. Oh, because that place is so good. I want to try the quiche, and what else do we want to try?
Quiche me outside, how about that?
I'm literally, before we get on the airplane, I'm going to eat so much because I want to like fill up, like I'm hibernating. And then get on the airplane for like 12 hours because I'm not gonna eat on the airplane. So just like get really full and then, yeah, that's.
When I get on airplanes, I tend to want to have like a gin and tonic and want to watch a ton of movies. I just like watching shows. I feel like I could check out on planes. I really like planes. I really like plane rides and flying because it's the one place that I just like. I ignore the stress of life and all of my responsibilities, and I just like
can just tune you're in the air like you're pill. Out of touch.
Yeah, I'm out of touch with the world. And
no
I'm just
service.
Like,
nobody can talk to
sometimes,
you.
Sometimes though, I'm in the chatty mood. I talk to the guy next to me.
Especially first class, like chat it up because it's very intimate. Like we're just remembering that we have a handshake. Hunter and I made in college. We were like so obsessed with each other. We still are.
What?
But just kidding. We made a handshake because we were like so dorky. And so he says he doesn't think I remember it, but I for sure do.
Alright, ready?
So let's do it. No, it's just one.
What was that part?
I don't know.
What do we used to do? Oh, no, wait.
We need a better ending.
I thought we'd come back.
Time this feels like something, and it's morning, and you leave, and then there's makeup on my pillowcase. Wake up with your aftertaste. Our body's burning up in flames, but all you do is slip away. So I hold you like fire, even though it hurts. So I hold you like fire, even though I might get burned. So I hold you like fire. Greatest time I learned to let you go.